Hello everyone. So today we're taking a quick look at the Samsung Galaxy S4's lock screen controls. So if you want to customise your Galaxy S4 and you're quite interested in kind of changing up how your lock screen functions, there's some very, very interesting features here. So what you need to do, come into settings first of all, go to My Device, and then come into the lock screen. And then from the lock screen, you've got a few different options, including multiple widgets. And this is a feature of Android 4.2. And it allows you to place widgets on your lock screen. Brilliant. Now, some of these widgets are already available from kind of Samsung, and they include things like your favorite apps or camera, or a personal message or a clock. And you can change exactly what you want to have featured there. You can just have the clock, or you can have it with the personal message, the Life Companion message. And if you want to, you can edit that message and set it to absolutely anything you like. And really cool, it's got customization options which still keep the kind of awesome look and feel. So if we go here, Androidism, and then if I want to, I can change the text. There's a few basically built in to begin with to give you a nice common look and feel. I've not found a way to actually change those fonts yet, but you can then also add various types of colour overlays, etc., or have it transparent. What type of font style you want, etc. Really, really nice. So that's a quick customization for the front screen. But then you've got shortcuts as well. Now going into shortcuts will allow you to put icons on the lock screen. So these icons you can customize. Now you want to be careful because security is a bit of an issue when you're using these lock screen icons, because effectively a person just has to touch and over the icon and it will automatically power up that particular application. Obviously, if it's your phone or your camera, that could cause you a few problems from a security point of view. So just be careful at which sort of shortcuts you decide to enable. You can show the help text on the lock screen as well, and you can also generate wake up commands as well. If you happen to be using the S voice function, you can basically say wake up Galaxy S or Hi Galaxy or anything like that, and the lock screen will automatically wake up. It's quite a nice idea. You've got unlock effects as well, which are currently greyed out because I've got one of the other features turned on. I think it's the multiple widgets. But effectively that just changes whether you get the ink effect or the nice light effect. Groovy. But let's go back now and let's have a look at the lock screen. Now we've made this change. Now, just get rid of that. Now if you swipe in from the side, it doesn't always work quite as reliably as I would like this. Samsung could do with making a little change. But it should allow you, there we go, to get into these widget areas. And from here, you can then pick any of your standard widgets that are already installed, or whatever you might choose. So for instance, I can have the Google Now widget appearing on my lock screen. If I want to, I can also put the Samsung Watch On application. So then I've got full control of my television, and I never have to actually log into the phone itself to get hold of it. I just swipe across, and then I've got my various infrared controls available there. If you swipe across to the other side, moving to the right as it were, left, hang on, which way are we flicking? We're flicking left. You have a series of quick launch applications, and again, mind your security on this particular feature. Do customize them to remove anything that you don't want to be present at the time. For instance, things like people can make phone calls or access your calendar or camera without actually having to log into the device. But these are really nice quick features, and it's quite nice to see that Samsung have integrated this with 4.2 quite cleanly. Do you know what I mean? It's not a janky implementation at all. It works really nicely. As you see there, nice and fluid. But that is a very quick look at what you can do with the Samsung Galaxy S4 lock screen. There's a lot of customization options here. You can really make these lock screens your own now, and with some really, really cool widget features as well. I think Google Now on your lock screen is just a great idea. But there you go, Galaxy S4 lock screen.